Hello, friends. It is Wednesday, April 3rd, and I'm back out here on my back patio just enjoying the breeze and the wind chime, and just a beautiful day. I hope that you're having an opportunity to do that as well. Again, it feels good to be outside enjoying a peaceful moment, and yet it really makes me and perhaps you mindful of all the places where there is not peace, where there is unrest in our nation today, as these protests continue and just the civil unrest and all these things that are going on. It's just along with the ongoing coronavirus and just it's a heavy time in our nation for sure. And yet we obviously just want to keep remembering that the Lamb is on his throne. I'm going to speak about that on Sunday with the passage from Revelation. Jesus is on the throne, and so we can trust that no matter what this world may throw at us, no matter what may be going on, that it doesn't change that fact. So I hope you take comfort in that today and every day, knowing that he is in control. And because of that, while we may have concerns and worries and fears at times, hopefully it puts to rest all of those on an ultimate level, because we know that Jesus holds everything in his hands. So today I just wanted to offer up a quick message. Just been thinking about this a lot today. One simple verse from Jesus' Sermon on the Mount, what's known as the Beatitudes, talking about the blessed ones. He says this in Matthew chapter 5, verse 9. Matthew 5, verse 9. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Or you could say children of God as well. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. What an appropriate verse for what we're dealing with today and have been dealing with in recent days and the recent week. You know, it's interesting, the Beatitudes, they're always such great... Sorry, my wind chime's getting going crazy, getting a little loud. We hear the Beatitudes, read the Beatitudes, and think they're great lessons for life, but oftentimes I don't think they mean as much or hit home as much. That one, the peacemakers, you know, I always just think of it in general, being people of peace, but it obviously is much more poignant right now in the midst of unrest. And so I think it's a verse, it's a word from Jesus that we really need to grab hold of today and remember that as God's children, as his chosen people, as his church, as Jesus' disciples, we are called to be peacemakers. So I just want to kind of lift it up to you, to me, to all of us today. What are we doing to promote peace? And are we promoting peace? Hopefully we all are, and not promoting or engaging in the opposite, in unrest or evil or wickedness or any of those things. I'm sure for most of us, likely all of us, we're not. But not only is it enough, I think, just to not be engaged in those things, but also how are we truly being active and engaging in peacemaking, especially when there's all this tension in our country right now. We need to be about that. I think now is a time where we really need to work, be about racial reconciliation, reaching across the racial divides. We really need to be about reaching across the political divides, the partisan divides. Our nation is so fractured politically right now, and that's only going to increase as we're coming up on we're in an election year coming up in November. So how are you reaching across the aisle to engage with people with whom you may disagree, perhaps even passionately? There's so much of that today. And so I just want to encourage us to be peacemakers, where I see so much discord is online and on social media and Facebook, and where everyone has to launch in with their opinions. And there's so much of that right now. What would it take to refrain? I really do try to refrain from those things, because as a pastor, as a Christian in general, but as a pastor, I reflect Jesus. And if I'm just going to launch in with something, that's not going to reflect well on him. It won't reflect well on me either, but it's definitely not going to reflect well on him. So oftentimes, even though when I might want to voice my opinion, I refrain from doing so. But there obviously are times where we must speak. But do we speak the truth in love? That's the ultimate guiding question for us. So today, again, I just want to encourage us to be peacemakers, to really take hold of that statement by Jesus, and to say we're going to be about promoting peace. And what does that look like in your life? What does it look like in my life? How can we do that, both racially, both politically, and in any other way? I think it's an important question for us. And remember, I do just want to say this, if the way that you've chosen to promote peace is through protest, as long as it is a peaceful protest, not only is that okay, but it's also your right. I mean, First Amendment to the Constitution says that we have the right to peacefully assemble, to peacefully protest. Where those things are happening around our nation is not only right, but it's needed. There's a need for that right now, just as there was back in the civil rights era with Martin Luther King leading the way. The right to peaceful protest in order to promote change when it's needed. And it is needed, and so there's a need for that, and that's appropriate. Where it obviously crosses that line is when it shifts over into violence and anarchy and all those things. Unfortunately, oftentimes it's the ones who are seeking to peacefully protest are not the ones engaged in those behaviors. Sometimes they are, because they've been pushed to that limit in some cases, but other times they're not the ones doing it. It's this whole others who show up and just want to be about trouble. And so if the way you feel called to be peacemakers is through peaceful protest, then God bless you in that. There's nothing wrong in that. That's a righteousness in doing that, as long as it is peaceful. But like I say, it can be to that extreme, or it can be as simple as what does your online engagement look like? How do you act on social media? Or how do you act in conversations with maybe a friend, a neighbor, a loved one with whom you disagree? Perhaps you're in different partisan sides of the aisle. Are you about peace, or is it just about the argument, the fight, the divisiveness? So I just want to encourage us today, let's commit today and moving forward, especially in these times of unrest, to be people of peace, to be peacemakers, because that is the way that we will reflect Jesus well in this time. So I'm excited tomorrow to record my sermon for Sunday, and I just eager, even though I'm daunted a bit, I'm eager to share the word that I think God has really placed on my heart. So hope you'll be blessed by that come Sunday. But like I said, for today, I just wanted to share this word. So God bless you. I hope you're all doing well and staying well and staying safe. And look forward to talking with you all again soon. Talk soon. God bless.